Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and today we are here again to create another 3D logo design. This logo is in perspective view, where on top surface you can see there is a hexagon. Four hexagon has been joined together and has been extruded to certain distance. So to design this logo, we'll first use the Polygon tool and create a hexagon. Then we'll create this basic shape by duplicating four hexagon. Then after that, we'll extrude it to certain distance with the help of Extrude Bevel option. Then we'll expand this and apply the particular gradient colors. So let's begin with tutorial. I'll just select the Polygon tool and left click my mouse button here. This palette will appear. Keep the radius around 40 points and size around 6 and click OK. So a hexagon is created. Now once you have created, make sure that the fill color is null and you have applied some stroke color and give the stroke points to around 9 points. So select it from here and give it 9 points. Now after giving that, just rotate this to an angle. So I'll rotate it with a shift press, rotate to 90 degree angle and place it like this. Now after that, we'll duplicate this with the alt press, just click, and with a shift press just drag and it will be aligned. In the same way, alt press, click, drag, with a shift press, it will be automatically aligned. Now I'll select these two and I'll duplicate this one more and push it upward and place it around here. Now I'll just make sure they are aligned. So I'll just click and drag this side and place it here. And I'll just see, make sure that they are in a okay. We have got certain gap. I'll just select this and let's push it a little bit down and let's check it out. Okay. We'll do a little bit more. So okay, so just make sure. Okay, fine. So once you have aligned everything, next thing is we'll select everything. Before that, just select this piece and delete it out. Select everything, go to object, path, outline stroke, and this will convert this into outline form. Now select everything. Now once you have done that, we'll select this piece and delete it out and select everything and go to object, path, and outline stroke, and this will convert this into fill object. Now after that, go to pathfinder and combine it. So this is now one object. Now next thing we'll do is we'll use the extrude bevel option. So select this piece and go to effect 3D extrude bevel. Now here we'll be doing certain settings. So let's check it out. I'll place it here. Now first I'll remove everything. So I'll just select 0, 0, 0, place everywhere. Now once you have done that, I'll just preview this and rotate it to certain angle. So I'll just check it out. Okay, that's good. So let's keep it around 30. Now I'll increase the perspective to around, let's check it out, 400. Okay, that's nice. Just make sure they are in particular shape. We can just increase it a little bit, like 120, 120 degree. Okay, that's good. Now just increase the extrude depth to around 80. Let's check it out. Okay, that's nice. And I'll just play with the angle a little bit, like that. 29 is good, or maybe 30. So okay, so I have given the first angle 30 and the perspective angle to 120 and extrude depth to 80 points and click OK. So I have created this basic shape. Now I select this and go to object, expand appearance. Once I've done that, I right click, ungroup, and ungroup. Now every piece is separate. Select everything and deselect this, and with the eye picker, with the alt and shift press, just select this and all the colors will be applied. In the same way, select this piece separately, with the eye picker select this color. Okay, so you got that. So now let's do the adjustments. So I select this V for selection and G for gradient tool, and let's do some adjustments. So let's do, like, I'll just make sure it's in an angle. Select this G, make sure it is an angle. In the same way, I'll select this G, make it some angle like that, giving it some angle like that. Okay, in the same way, select these pieces and do the same stuff, like giving it some gradient adjusting the gradients and making sure it looks good. So we are doing that. Okay, that's fine. Select this, G, apply it. Okay, like that. So V for selection, G, apply it that way, V, G, apply this. Okay, giving it nice gradient and nice angle. Select this, apply it. If it's not, just correct it. Now select this, G, apply it. Make sure it's in nice, forming a nice shape like this. Okay, you can just make sure by individually editing the gradient tool. With the gradient tool, G, V for selection, G for gradient, apply it properly. V, G, apply it. Just make sure the perfect angle. Okay. And apply it. So let's check it out. Okay, we have applied all the gradient colors in a proper order. We need to do a little adjustment here, G, and I'll just give some dark tone here, giving it some corner feel. In the same way, let's check it out what else we can do here. Okay, this is giving nice look. Let's check it out here. Okay, let's give some little adjustment here, G, and I'll just give some angle to this so that I can give some dark shade here. Okay, this is good. Let's check it out. Okay, this one. Okay, a little bit here, G, make it a little bit straight so that I can see this cut like that, and I'll just push it down. Select this, G, and make sure to give some dark tone here. So now we have done with all these extruded shapes. We are left with only this shape. So I'll select the G and make sure to apply it in this way, straight. You can do the adjustment, you can make it a little bit shorter here, and let's see. Okay, so we have designed this, we have applied all the gradient color in a particular order, and it's looking and it's final. Last thing we are left with is the text. So I'll type out the text with a caps lock on AREAL, AREAL, and the font which we are using here is DWSendMD. So here is the font, you can find it on the font family here, and the font size which you're using is regular, and let's reduce the font size a little bit and go to character, and let's give 2000 and enter. Okay, now I'll just place it for a while here, and before that I'll just scale this design. So I'll just scale this up to match with our logo here. Okay, and I'll place it here, and I'll reduce the font size to around 24, and let's place it in a proper way. Now last thing we're left with is with the color. So I'll just choose this color from here with the art picker. I just select this. Okay, and let's keep the font to 24 again, and fine. So finally we have created this amazing logo. We have used the 3D Extrude Bevel option in a very nice way. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more evidence of designing, you can press the subscribe button. For business inquiry, you can check out the email address on the screen, and also you'll find it on the description below. Thank you.